they presented a revised version of the Raleigh redefined, which showed images of the entrance and lakes, the library and police buildings. It included green spaces, a 1 mile walking trail, a state-of-the-art skateboard park, and many other features. They also added a picture of the beautiful new Welcome Raleigh sign, which will improve the community identity. Mr. Marshall asked Councilman Bill Morrison to come forward following his presentation to make a very important announcement. Councilman Morrison invited everyone to come to the Raleigh Springs Mall on Saturday, May 7th at 10:30 a.m. to witness the demolition of the Sears Automotive Building, the first of many to be demolished. There will be music and food for everyone. Mayor Jim Strickland will be there, which he was. Please invite your friends and neighbors to be there to witness the first step of the accumulation of all of our hard work. On the business meeting, there were no minutes for the April 7th meeting. The treasurer's report by Zed Beatty was ill, and there is no report. He is still ill, for those of you who don't know, and so we don't have a current treasurer's report right now, but basically nothing of significance has changed. President Morrison asked Aaron Fowles to speak at the June 2nd meeting. Aaron shared that this will be an expansion on the common goals identified in the April meeting. We will work on goals and build plans which will lead to a radically redefined Raleigh. The meeting will be held in a fellowship hall, so seating will be around the tables. He also announced two upcoming events. Number one, the volunteer code enforcement classes given by Otis Tidwell will be held on May 7th from 10 a.m. to 12 noon at the main library. There will be a code enforcement suite of District 1 and District 8 held May 23rd to 30th. May 28th and 29th has been designated for neighborhood projects. President Morrison called attention to the six new RCC banners announcing our meetings, which are in prominent places at entrances to Raleigh. Thank you, Commissioner Brooks, for the grant money which purchased the banners, and thank you to Kevin Brooks, who puts up and takes down the signs each month. The July 7th meeting will be held, will be our ice cream fest, and which will be held downstairs. The council will furnish the ice cream. Everyone is asked to bring toppings and anything else that goes with ice cream. We will have a guest speaker. That guest speaker will be Antonio Parkinson. President Morrison recognized three members of the RCC board who have served many years and requested to be replaced. That was Alice Chandler, Sue Baker, and Martha Edwards. She then introduced three members who will join the board, which is Joy Stewart, Frieda Hopkins, and Maggie Cruthard. New business was Kevin Brooks announced that there will be a Christian mobile dental clinic sponsored by Scenic Hills United Methodist Church to be held on June 1st to June 4th from 7 a.m. to 3 p.m. This is for people who live in the 38127 and 38128 zip codes and who do not have dental insurance. For an appointment, call Barbara at 265-0945. Ms. Evelyn Young introduced herself to the group. She is the new director of the Raleigh Community Center at 3678 Powers Road. There will be two upcoming events, the Ice Cream Social, May 13th at 4 to 6 p.m., and a bazaar on June 14th, in which tables can be rented. In the attendance, there were 140 people in attendance. There were several first-time attendees, and the meeting was adjourned at 7:50 p.m. Are there any additions or corrections to these minutes? Within these, stand approved. At this time, I'd like to basically turn the meeting over to Aaron Fowles and Kevin Brooks. They're going to be telling us how the best way for us to proceed with this meeting and the different tables and areas.
Sure, what am I recording?
And so here and there.
Thank you. I'm not going to use the microphone. It makes me stoop over. Remember 2 months ago, we were down here. We had all the papers along the wall, and people kind of shared ideas about what they thought was important in Raleigh, things that were that were really good and things that we had opportunities to improve upon. So what I did, my wife did a lot of it, we took those ideas and collated them into kind of similar groupings for ideas that we can actually work on. And the, at the table, we've got home ownership was a really big concern. A lot of people complained about renters and what they do to the property and property values. So this table over here is for talking about how to improve home ownership. There's one really, really kind of radical idea, and that's forming a community development corporation, which they have. There are community development corporations all throughout the city. Fraser CDC is a big one, but Midtown has a community development corporation. New Chicago has a community development corporation. Hyde Park has a community development corporation. And what a community development corporation is a nonprofit organization that essentially tries to solidify the housing base of an area, of a specified geographical area, purchasing homes, renting them perhaps, but also trying to push towards home ownership, oftentimes in the using like a lease purchase option for people who can't necessarily afford a traditional mortgage, but are maybe able to kind of build something while renting. So that is a discussion that can be had, well, it can be had anywhere, but the paper for it is here. This table is dedicated to cleanliness. Raise your hand if you've had a cleanliness issue in Raleigh. Okay, if you ever seen some litter somewhere, you didn't want to see litter, that's there. Back there is the youth and schools table. Opportunities for young people are lacking, some people think. I think we have a lot of opportunities in Raleigh. The community center's got a lot of opportunities. The town center's gonna have opportunities, but I remember 2 months ago, Kevin Brooks mentioned a Saturday Scholars Program. So what can the community do to help support the kids who are here? Back table there is safety. Anyone had a crime problem? Anyone?
Not yet.
Bond, you may just want to go ahead and shift over there. You'll be, your expertise will be valued. You can, Ms. Bond, I'm not going to tell you where you can go. You can do what you'd like. Back table over there, business outreach. Business outreach. We have a lot of businesses in Raleigh. Some people think there should be different kinds of businesses. I would love to see a coffee shop in this city, in this part of town. I have to drive all over Creation if I want to get a coffee that's not Starbucks. So if we, that's an opportunity, business outreach. This table is general outreach. How do we unify the churches in our community? How do we get the different churches working together? How do we get the churches and the mosques and the temples and the synagogues working together, which is a really touchy issue for a lot of people? How do we get our schools working together? How can we support our schools? You know, the schools committee might have a great idea, but if we're not networked with our schools, what does that do? I want you all to think about the last time you told somebody that you live in Raleigh. What kind of image did the person you're talking to have of your community? Do you think the person you were speaking to thought, well, that's a great place? That's simply not the case. The perception of Raleigh is really negative. Hence, a promotions committee. A promotions committee, right? What can we do to promote our community, to make people want to move here, to buy our homes, to increase our property values, and to drive out the negative elements that make everyone stay up at night? Health. What opportunities do we have to improve? The greatest wealth is health, right? If you don't have health, nothing else matters. So what can we do to improve our health? So as we're thinking about these things, I'm going to take you through a brief PowerPoint presentation. Okay? If you remember, Tom Marshall, when he gave his slideshow, mentioned Raleigh Redefined. And I put this in the newsletter, and Faye Morrison asked me if I thought it was a good idea to put, who knows what this is called, when you put a pound sign and then a word after it. There's a fancy term for it.
Hashtag.
Millennials and younger?
Hashtag.
Hashtag, right? If you are active in social media, if you're active in social media and you want to talk about what you're doing, put that on there. You know, there are, Arab Spring was driven by like this internet hashtag. And social media is a really cool way to reach a lot of people. We have that as one of our things that's available to us. Now, how are we going to redefine Raleigh? And it is as simple as A, B, C, D. I've been doing a lot of reading on this. Asset-based community development. I want you all to remember that. A, B, C, D. Asset-based community development. You can Google that. It's a real term. What it means is we don't view ourselves as a collection of deficiencies. We don't view our neighborhood as a deficient place. We view our neighborhood as a place that is full of assets. Right? Now, what is an asset? That's a very cyclical term. Some people define asset as something that will generate more assets, right? Which just leads to a lot of jokes eventually. But we can define an asset as something that will improve our quality of life. Something that we can use to improve our quality of life. And there are seven kinds of, it's like school, y'all are taking notes, right? I'm a school teacher, so I'm very natural with this. There are seven kinds of assets that we're gonna think about. Seven kinds of assets. Y'all can remember asset-based community development? A, B, C, D, okay? Seven kinds of assets. Human assets. Looking at you. Everyone in this room is a human asset. Raise your hand if you know how to do something really well. Your hand's not raised, because, okay. Can you all do something really, really well? Maybe better than anyone in this room? Maybe better than anyone on the street? Is there one thing that you can do? It's easy to view yourself in terms of deficiencies. I can't do this, I can't do that. How many of you can write a letter? How many, you know, people my age, we can't do it. Not to save our lives. You know, how many of you can sit and make a phone call? How many of you could sit and canvas people and talk to people, right? You are a human asset. Your know-how is valuable. Physical capital. What do we? I have a DIY ADD, do-it-yourself attention deficit disorder. I have a problem in my house. I don't even look at my toolbox. I just go to the store and buy more tools, okay? Because I just forget what I have. And so I'm collecting tools. So who's been doing that for about 20 years? Anyone?
30 years?
We got a collection of tools.
Yeah.
So Kevin's got a collection of tools and a bunch of know-how. Well, there's a very useful thing right there.
I don't know.
Think about the homes in our community. Think about that vacant property on your street or in your neighborhood that's currently got a lot of weeds growing at it. You can view that as a deficiency, but we can also view that as a physical asset to our community, because that home can be leveraged to create a better neighborhood, to create a better community. That's a physical asset, financial asset, that shouldn't need much explanation. Now, I don't know if anyone in this room is independently wealthy. I'm not. Does anyone in this room know somebody who's independently wealthy? I do. I'm not ashamed. I mean, if you know somebody who's independently wealthy, that is a financial asset. Environmental asset. Memphis has got some huge environmental assets as a city. The Memphis Sands Aquifer is an environmental asset. The Mississippi River is an environmental asset. Kennedy Park is an environmental asset. I live in Scenic Hills, and you cannot reproduce our trees. Those are our environmental asset. We cannot build it. We can't grow. I mean, we can't buy it. Those are just a part of what we've got. And Raleigh has got environmental assets. Political assets. We have representation in Raleigh. I think we're pretty good. We've got a really active school board member, and I'm not supporting anyone, but we have school board members. We have state representatives. We have a city councilman who's active with the Raleigh Community Council. We have federal representatives. We have political assets, people who can represent us in other places. We have cultural capital. You ever drive down Stage Road between Warford and Hollywood, and you're under the underpass, and you see those beautiful murals on the side of the road? under the underpass. It's right near between Scenic Hills and Sky Lake. I smile every time I drive past it. And I try to...
You don't get all that.
I did at one point. I can find out for you.
That's wonderful.
Okay, and how many cultural assets do we have in Raleigh? And can we develop our cultural assets? Right? Outreach, business outreach. We can develop our cultural assets in Raleigh. I'm not even sure if we have a movie theater in Raleigh to speak of. Now that I think about it. Okay. So let's think about what do we have when we build on that? Our social assets. Like I said, I'm not independently wealthy. I know an independently wealthy person. That's a social asset. Every time you get together with your neighborhood, you're developing social assets. You're building those connections. That leads to something else down the line. So these assets are the A in asset-based community development. So at your table, can I borrow this? Okay. We have the name here. These are some opportunities. These were generated by you. I didn't write these. These were things that people in the community made. Are the things that they want to improve upon. The things that we want to do. I had to draw the box for assets because I forgot to put it on the document. In your working group, think about what assets we currently have in our community to help achieve these opportunities. I've also written a vision for each community, for health. I wrote a community where everyone has the ability to be healthy. This is what I personally would love to see happen. My home ownership, I feel very invested in the home ownership one, by the way, so I'm gonna hang out over here. 100% responsible home ownership. 100% responsible home ownership. Raise your hand if you think that's probable. Probably not. I think it's possible. I think it's possible. It's not immediately probable. Nope. 30% of real estate purchases in the first quarter of 2016 were rental homes. 30%. Mm-hmm. Memphis cash flow is buying up my neighborhood. Mm-hmm. They're buying up my neighborhood. But I personally have a vision. I see it in my head. I mean, this is like Mr. Rogers meets every like 60s, 70s sitcom you can imagine. Okay? That's what's in my head. 100% responsible home ownership. You know, call me crazy. And then, members, those are you, chair, I want someone to take responsibility for this. If nobody wants to take responsibility for this, it goes in the garbage. Okay? Mission statement. How are we going to achieve what we're going to do? But the most important thing here is the action steps. Because we can meet and meet and meet and meet till we're blue in the face, but nothing matters unless we actually do something outside of the first Thursday of every month. So this is what I want you to come up with in your working group this evening. Each one of these papers that has a chair and a couple of members and some action steps lives after this evening. Any piece of paper that does not have a chair, some members, and some action steps dies this evening. Because we're not going to beat a dead horse. We're going to think about developing our community in a way that makes sense for us. So I encourage you. So I've got home ownership here, health, outreach, which is very general, business outreach, maybe those tables could join. I've got promotions, we need to make Raleigh look better, opportunities, parades, Raleigh Day, Fraser's got Fraser Day, I want Raleigh Day, health,
safety,
I want to walk around at night without feeling like I need to have a golf club. Cleanliness here and youth in schools. I'm a teacher, I'm naturally invested in that, but we have a lot of human capital dealing with that right now. So by the end of, it's 7:23 now, I'm not gonna kick you out. You know, we can stay here as long as we need to stay here. If we, until we get some working plans done, some ideas. I'm not saying you have to, you're dedicating yourself to a proposition this evening, but you're dedicating your thought process, and you might be dedicating a little bit more of your time than you've normally dedicated toward, to these pursuits. So, get to it. Right? Let's see where we are in half an hour. Maybe we'll be done. All right? I'll be walking around, but if anyone wants to join me at the homeownership table, I'm not going to be.
Can we go back to what you wanted
to do? To help you think a little better, there's coffee, there's a coffee thing, and there's cold drinks over here, and ice, help yourself.
Hi there. Y'all, latecomers, read that.
What do we got there?
Promotions.
Give us some ideas.
All right. Promotions, we might be able to somehow or another promote, like the farm over there, Windermere Farm, or it's a fresh, you know, organic farm. Yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah. That might be something that we can wind up saying, hey, look, we've got it right here. Yeah. That would be one thing that we could run.
Because I know somebody that used to have a concession stand and get their
I'm just going to
The gambler goes. Thank you. That's Thank you. Some of them are sitting up there.
The deal has turned into